Barbie and Oppenheimer fever, which continues to rule at the box office. The Margot Robbie starrer Barbie, directed by Greta Gerwig and co-starring Ryan Gosling, has broken multiple records at the box office. It's the largest domestic opening of 2023 so far, drawing in approximately $162 million on its opening weekend. It's also the largest opening for a female-directed film in domestic markets, topping Captain Marvel and Wonder Woman. But on a global level, it's a second highest opening for a movie from a woman filmmaker, second to Captain Marvel. Then, Cillian Murphy starrer Oppenheimer, based on the father of the atomic bomb and the events that led up to the Hiroshima and Nagasaki bombings, and directed by Christopher Nolan, is sparking conversations about method acting owing to the rumor of him skipping cast dinners and eating an almond instead. Robert Downey Jr.'s character role is also being lauded, and you'll have to watch it to understand why so. Let's try and understand this entire phenomena called Barbenheimer. And for that, let me introduce my guest. I'm joined in by Seth Schachner, who's the MD of Strat Americas, a digital business executive as well. Thank you so much, Seth, for joining in. Barbenheimer is more than just a meme now. It's become unequivocally the great box office performance for cinema goers. It's a full-fledged box office phenomenon. What explains such love for Barbie especially?
Yeah, I think it's enormous. It's interesting to hear some of the traditional retail and just traditional film marketing, you know, techniques and programs being mentioned. I think that's a big part of it. There's certainly a big product blitz. This is Mattel's. This is a major consumer products company. But I point out social media as increasingly one of the very biggest factors in breaking a picture, whether that's TikTok or other social media, and you know, the activities that are coming from that, just the virality, if you will, that I think is probably you know, in its own way creating network effects for people going into the theaters, awareness translating into theater going. You know, I think all those things combined with the retail, social networking, just the general idea that people are aware of this, have kind of created a 1-2 punch to get people back into theaters. It's almost like it's an event where if you don't go to it, you have this sort of fear of missing out, if you will. So it's a lot of factors coming together, and you know, maybe you won't see that going forward.
Thank you for sharing those inputs, Seth. It was a pleasure to have you on the show.